Welcome to Relaxing Boutique Channel. Finding moments of peace in the hustle and bustle of our lives can be a bit challenging. Our channel is your sanctuary, a place where captivating tales blend with soothing tones, guiding you toward restful slumber. Escape from the noise, let go of the day's stresses, and allow our stories to transport you to realms of tranquility and dreams. Whether you're seeking relaxation, meditation, or simply a good night's sleep, you're in the right place. So, settle in, close your eyes, and let the journey to serenity begin. In our unceasing journey through the corridors of life, moments of pure, unadulterated tranquility can sometimes seem as elusive as shadows at noon. The modern world is a symphony of endless noises, from the incessant hum of digital screens to the ceaseless whispers of obligations, commitments, and desires. In this symphony, our souls often search for a gentle lullaby, a melodious escape, a chance to pause, breathe, and simply be. Now, as you find yourself here in the magic of this narrative oasis, know that you've stumbled upon a sanctuary, a world where serenity isn't just a luxury, but a promise. Picture, if you will, a secluded haven nestled amidst nature's embrace, where the wind hums lullabies, and time itself seems to tread lightly. This is where we invite you to journey with us, a place of meditation, reflection, and utter calm. Begin by taking a deep, resolute breath. Feel the cool air grace your nostrils, traveling through the depths of your lungs, filling your being with the ancient rhythms of existence. And then, as you exhale, imagine releasing the shackles of worry, stress, and the relentless march of time. Each subsequent breath is a step deeper into the heart of tranquility, a dance with the universe, an affirmation of the present moment. We live in an era where the very essence of our existence often feels fragmented. Pulled in myriad directions by demands, expectations, and the invisible threads of technology, it's easy to lose oneself. But these tales, each a gem sculpted from the rich tapestries of imagination and insight, seek to offer you a bridge. A bridge not just to sleep, but that in itself is a cherished realm of restoration, but to a state of soulful relaxation, where the world narrows down to the here and now, where every heartbeat is a reminder of life's simple beauties. These stories are not just words. They are portals. They beckon you into worlds where the pace is gentler, the colors more vivid, and the sounds harmoniously aligned with the rhythms of the cosmos. Here, amidst these tales, you'll find characters and landscapes that resonate with the deepest parts of your psyche, invoking a sense of familiarity and nostalgia. They're like old friends or forgotten dreams, waiting to welcome you back. As you immerse yourself in these narratives, let the outside world fade into soft focus. Envision your stresses and anxieties as leaves carried away by a gentle stream, disappearing beyond the horizon. Let the weight of expectation, the clamor of responsibilities, and the noise of uncertainty be replaced by the soothing cadences of these stories. Every word, every phrase, is a brushstroke painting a world of peace, inviting you to step in and explore. Sleep, that precious gift, is not just a physical necessity but a balm for the soul. It's nature's way of healing, restoring, and rejuvenating. As you stand at the threshold of dreams, these tales are the gentle hands guiding you towards restful slumber. They remind you of the beauty of surrender, of letting go, of drifting into the comforting embrace of night. So, dear listener, as you embark on this journey with us, know that you are not alone. Through the magic of these tales, we are with you, sharing in your quest for tranquility and deep, restorative sleep. Let these stories be your anchor, your lighthouse, guiding you away from the tempests of daily life and into the calm waters of relaxation and dreams. Welcome to our sanctuary. Let the journey to serenity begin. Shadows of the Vatican. Chapter 1. The Hidden Message. Marco Bellini, a skilled art restorer, stood in the quiet solitude of his workshop within the Vatican. He was surrounded by the remnants of history, each piece a silent testament to the past. Today, he was engrossed in the restoration of a Renaissance-era painting, a lesser-known work attributed to a disciple of Raphael. Its vibrant hues had faded over time, but its beauty was still evident. The painting depicted a typical biblical scene, but as Marco meticulously cleaned years of grime and old varnish, he noticed something unusual. Hidden in the corner of the canvas, almost imperceptible, were faint lines forming a symbol not congruent with the rest of the painting. It was an anachronism, a deliberate addition that seemed out of place. Intrigued, Marco took a closer look, using his magnifying glass. The symbol was a complex geometric shape, interwoven with what appeared to be letters in an archaic script. It was as if the artist had left a message, a secret meant to be discovered centuries later. His curiosity aroused Marco. Despite working on Renaissance art restoration for years, he had never come across anything quite like this. None of the in-depth documentation or analysis of the painting made reference to the sign. It was a mystery that was there to be seen. He decided to consult the Vatican archives for any clues. The archives were a treasure trove of historical documents, some dating back to the earliest days of the Church. Gaining access was not easy, given the stringent restrictions, but Marco's position and reputation within the Vatican granted him a certain level of clearance. As he delved into the archives, Marco was enveloped by the scent of old parchment and the silent way of history. He sifted through manuscripts, letters, and records from the Renaissance period, looking for any reference to the symbol or the painting. Hours turned into days, and the search seemed fruitless until he stumbled upon an old, forgotten letter penned by a contemporary of Raphael. The letter, written in a cryptic tone, hinted at a hidden knowledge, a secret that the writer and a select few were privy to. It mentioned a symbol, a key to unlocking this hidden knowledge. The description in the letter matched the symbol on the painting. Marco's heart raced as he realized the magnitude of his discovery. The painting he was restoring was more than just a religious depiction. It was a map or a key to something much greater, possibly a hidden aspect of Renaissance history. The letter also referenced other works of art from the same period, suggesting that this secret was part of a larger tapestry woven into the fabric of Renaissance art. Marco knew he had to tread carefully. A discovery of this nature had the potential to rewrite history or shake the very foundations of widely accepted narratives. He decided to keep his discovery confidential, fearing the repercussions it could bring. The Vatican, with its centuries of influence and power, had secrets it preferred to keep hidden. Marco was aware that his discovery could put him in a precarious position. Over the next few weeks, Marco continued his restoration work, but now with a new perspective. He examined every inch of the painting, looking for more clues. As he worked, he couldn't help but wonder about the artist who had created it. What secret was so important that it had to be hidden in a painting? The symbol became an obsession for Marco. He spent every spare moment in the archives, piecing together a puzzle that spanned centuries. The more he discovered, the more he realized that the Renaissance was not just a time of artistic and cultural revival, but also of secret societies, hidden knowledge, and political intrigue. Marco's investigation led him to other artworks from the same period, each containing similar symbols and cryptic messages. It was as if a secret network of artists had been communicating through their art, passing along knowledge hidden from the rest of the world. The discovery of the hidden message in the painting had started as a small curiosity, but it had quickly evolved into a journey into the depths of history. Marco found himself at the crossroads of a mystery that spanned centuries, a secret that had been waiting to be uncovered in the shadows of the Vatican. As he stood in his workshop, the painting before him, Marco realized that he was about to embark on a journey that could change his life forever. The hidden message was a door to the past, beckoning him to step through and uncover the secrets that lay on the other side. In the heart of the Vatican, surrounded by the legacy of centuries, the painting and its hidden message were a whisper from the past, a call to unravel a mystery that had been silent for too long. Chapter 2: The Secret Archives. Marco Bellini, armed with the knowledge of the secret symbol and the cryptic letter, ventured deeper into the labyrinth of the Vatican. The secret archives were a realm of their own, a place where history lay preserved in the silence of time. The air was thick with the musk of ancient parchment and leather, a scent that spoke of centuries-old secrets. The archives were vast, stretching beneath the Vatican in a series of interconnected chambers and halls filled with manuscripts, scrolls, and documents from every era of the Church's existence. Marco, with his limited access, could only explore a fraction of this treasure trove, but even that was enough to immerse him in the whispers of the past. As he scoured through the ancient texts, Marco's thoughts kept returning to the Renaissance, a period known for its artistic brilliance and intellectual awakening, but also for its political machinations and secretive societies. The symbol in the painting was undoubtedly a piece of this intricate historical tapestry. Days turned into weeks as Marco delved into the documents. He pieced together fragments of information, mapping out connections between various Renaissance figures, artists, thinkers, church officials, and patrons. The more he read, the more he realized that the Renaissance was not just a period of enlightenment, but also one of intricate codes and hidden messages. He uncovered references to a secretive group, possibly an alliance of artists and intellectuals who communicated through symbols and allegories in their works. This group seemed to have a purpose beyond mere artistic expression. They were guardians of knowledge, a knowledge that was deemed dangerous or heretical at the time. Amidst the dusty tomes and fading ink, Marco found hints of this group's existence, subtle references in letters, vague mentions in diaries, and cryptic notes in the margins of manuscripts. The symbol in the painting appeared in various forms, a thread connecting these disparate pieces of information. One day, while examining a manuscript detailing the correspondence between prominent Renaissance artists, Marco came across a letter that mentioned a meeting of minds in the heart of Rome. The letter was vague, but it contained the same symbol, subtly embedded in the script. This meeting of minds was a pivotal point in Marco's search. It suggested a gathering of the secretive group, a convergence of the greatest minds of the time. He theorized that this meeting might have been where strategies were devised, knowledge was shared, and plans were laid down for the preservation and dissemination of their hidden truths. Marco's discovery was groundbreaking, but it also put him in a precarious position. The Vatican was not just a religious institution, it was a repository of history, some of which was closely guarded. The knowledge he was uncovering could challenge long-held beliefs and historical narratives. His work in the archives was not unnoticed. Marco felt the watchful eyes of the Vatican on him, a sense of being monitored. The deeper he delved into the mystery, the more he felt the weight of the Church's power and its desire to keep certain chapters of history closed. Despite the growing sense of unease, Marco's resolve only strengthened. He knew he was on the brink of uncovering something monumental, a revelation that could shed new light on the Renaissance and its legacy. The pieces of the puzzle were slowly coming together, but the full picture was still elusive. The manuscript with the letter about the meeting of minds became the key focus of his investigation. He believed that if he could pinpoint the location and time of this meeting, he might be able to uncover the group's ultimate purpose and the true significance of the symbol. As Marco continued his research, he also began to discreetly reach out to experts in Renaissance art and history, scholars who might help him decode the mysteries he was unraveling. He shared his findings with a select few, those he trusted and who shared his passion for historical truth. One such expert was Professor Elena Visconti, a renowned historian specializing in Renaissance art. Elena, intrigued by Marco's findings, agreed to collaborate with him. Together, they began to piece together the enigmatic history hidden within the Vatican's walls. Their collaboration led them to explore not just the archives, but also the art and architecture of the Vatican itself. They examined frescoes, sculptures, and architectural details, looking for the symbol and any related clues. One evening, while studying the frescoes in one of the lesser-known chapels, they discovered a series of hidden symbols, expertly woven into the artwork. These symbols matched the one in the painting Marco was restoring and seemed to form a pattern or a map. This discovery was a breakthrough. It suggested that the entire Vatican was a canvas for this secretive group, a place where they had hidden their knowledge in plain sight, under the guise of religious art. As Marco and Elena deciphered the symbols, they realized that they were not just uncovering a story of art and intrigue, they were unraveling a historical narrative that had been deliberately obscured, a narrative that held the potential to change the understanding of one of history's most vibrant periods. In the hallowed halls of the Vatican, amidst the shadows of history, Marco Bellini found himself at the center of a mystery that spanned centuries. His discovery in the painting had opened a door to the past, revealing a web of secrets and knowledge that had been waiting in the shadows, hidden in the art and archives of one of the world's most powerful institutions. Chapter 3. Unraveling the Past. It had been an exciting but difficult trip for Marco Bellini and Professor Elena Visconti to uncover the hidden symbols in the frescoes of the Vatican. They set out on a mission to decipher the complex web that a covert organization of Renaissance intellectuals and artists had built. As they decoded the symbols, they uncovered references to meetings and exchanges of ideas that had taken place in clandestine locations throughout Rome. These gatherings seemed to involve discussions on subjects that ranged from art and philosophy to science and theology, often challenging the orthodox beliefs of the time. One of the most striking findings was a series of letters exchanged between renowned Renaissance figures. These letters, skillfully hidden within the Vatican archives, spoke of a new dawn, a movement that sought to illuminate the world with knowledge and free thought, at a time when such ideals were often met with resistance and persecution. The letters also hinted at a significant event, a grand assembly of the minds where a pivotal decision was made. This event, referred to as the Night of the Hidden Sun, was purportedly where this group of intellectuals and artists shared their most radical ideas and laid down plans to safeguard their knowledge for future generations. Marco and Elena realized that this event might have been the culmination of the group's efforts and the key to understanding the true purpose of the hidden symbols and messages. They hypothesized that the group might have created a series of works, paintings, sculptures, architectural designs that contained encoded knowledge, a legacy meant to be discovered when the world was ready. Their investigation took them beyond the confines of the Vatican. They explored churches, libraries, and ancient sites throughout Rome, each location revealing a piece of the puzzle. The Pantheon, with its perfect geometric proportions, the Sistine Chapel with its enigmatic frescoes, and the hidden chambers beneath the Basilica of San Clemente, all bore silent witness to the group's influence. One particular breakthrough came when examining the works of Leonardo da Vinci. In one of his lesser-known sketches, they found a reference to the Night of the Hidden Sun. The sketch depicted a celestial event, an alignment of stars that occurred once in several centuries. The next occurrence of this event was approaching, and Marco and Elena speculated that it might be the key to unlocking the final secrets of the group. The closer they got to the truth, the more they felt the weight of history pressing down on them. They were acutely aware that their discoveries could have far-reaching implications. The knowledge hidden by the group had the power to challenge long-established narratives and beliefs. Their quest also attracted attention from various quarters. Scholars and historians expressed both excitement and skepticism about their findings, while higher-ups in the Vatican exhibited a growing unease about their investigations. There were moments when Marco and Elena felt the prying eyes of unseen watchers, reminding them of the delicate nature of their endeavor. Amidst the maze of history and conspiracy, a profound respect and camaraderie developed between Marco and Elena. They found solace in each other's passion for the truth and determination to bring the hidden knowledge to light. As they pieced together the map of hidden knowledge spread across Rome, they prepared for the upcoming celestial event, the night that could reveal the ultimate secret of the Renaissance group. They theorized that this event would unlock a final piece, perhaps a physical location or an artifact that was the culmination of the group's work. The night of the celestial event arrived. Marco and Elena, along with a small group of trusted scholars, gathered at a specific location in Rome that aligned with the symbols and the celestial map they had deciphered. As the stars aligned, a hidden mechanism in an ancient statue was triggered, revealing a secret compartment. Inside, they found a collection of documents and objects, scientific treatises, philosophical essays, and prototypes of inventions far ahead of their time. It was the legacy of the Renaissance group, a treasure trove of knowledge and ideas that were centuries ahead. The discovery was more than just historical artifacts. It was a testament to the enduring power of human thought and the unrelenting quest for understanding. The group had successfully safeguarded their legacy, passing it down through the ages, waiting for a time when the world would be ready to embrace their revolutionary ideas. As dawn broke, marking the end of the celestial event, Marco and Elena looked at each other, realizing the magnitude of what they had uncovered. They had unearthed a chapter of history that had remained hidden for centuries, a narrative that spoke of the unyielding human spirit and its pursuit of knowledge and truth. In the heart of Rome, under the same stars that had shone down on the Renaissance masters, Marco and Elena knew that their lives had been irrevocably changed. They had unraveled a mystery that bridged the past and the present, a mystery that had illuminated the shadows of history with the light of understanding. The documents and artifacts they found were more than just relics. They were beacons of a forgotten era, embers of a flame that had burned fiercely in the hearts of some of history's greatest minds. The treatises contained groundbreaking ideas in science and philosophy. The essays were bold proclamations of free thought and expression, and the inventions were blueprints of a future that could have been. As the new day dawned, Marco and Elena faced a crucial decision. The knowledge they had uncovered could change the understanding of the Renaissance and its impact on the modern world. However, they also knew that revealing this knowledge would challenge long-established narratives and could potentially provoke controversy and opposition. After much deliberation, they decided to share their findings with the world. They believed that the truth, no matter how disruptive, deserved to be known. The legacy of the Renaissance group, their courage in the pursuit of knowledge and freedom of thought, had to be honored and preserved. They organized a symposium, inviting scholars, historians, and scientists from around the world to witness the unveiling of the Renaissance group's legacy. The event was a convergence of minds, a modern-day echo of the historical meetings that had taken place centuries ago. The revelation of the findings sent ripples through academic and cultural circles. Some greeted the discovery with enthusiasm and wonder, while others approached it with skepticism and caution. But for Marco and Elena, the truth they had uncovered was a vindication of their relentless pursuit and a fulfillment of their responsibility to history. The legacy of the Renaissance group, once hidden in the shadows, now shone brightly, casting new light on the past and inspiring future generations to seek knowledge and truth. Marco and Elena, once mere stewards of history, had become part of the story themselves, guardians of a legacy that transcended time. In the heart of the Vatican, where the journey had begun, the shadows of the past had been dispelled, revealing a tapestry of human endeavor that was as beautiful as it was complex. The story of Shadows of the Vatican was a testament to the enduring quest for understanding, a journey through history that had brought to light the timeless pursuit of knowledge and the unquenchable human spirit. Chapter 4. The Revelation. The symposium organized by Marco Bellini and Professor Elena Visconti in the heart of Rome was a historic event, attended by some of the world's most esteemed scholars, historians, and scientists. The grand hall chosen for the event was filled with an air of anticipation as attendees awaited the revelation of the secret legacy of the Renaissance group. As the symposium commenced, Marco and Elena took to the stage, their presence commanding the attention of every individual in the room. They began by recounting their journey, the discovery of the hidden message in the Renaissance painting, the exploration of the Vatican's secret archives, and the decoding of symbols that led them to the night of the celestial event. They unveiled the artifacts and documents they had discovered, each item carefully preserved and displayed. The audience was captivated by the sight of these historical treasures, some of which challenged the very foundation of their understanding of the Renaissance period. Marco and Elena presented the treatises on science and philosophy, revealing ideas and theories that were far ahead of their time. These documents suggested that members of the Renaissance group had made significant advances in various fields, from astronomy to engineering, which have remained hidden for centuries. The essays on freedom of thought and expression painted a picture of a group of intellectuals who valued the pursuit of knowledge and the sharing of ideas, often at great personal risk. These writings offered a new perspective on the intellectual climate of the Renaissance, highlighting a vibrant undercurrent of progressive thought. The blueprints of inventions showcased the ingenuity and foresight of the group's members. Among these were designs for machines and devices that bore striking resemblances to modern-day inventions, indicating that the seeds of these ideas had been sown much earlier than previously believed. As the revelations unfolded, the symposium became more than just a presentation of historical findings. It turned into a forum for debate and discussion, with scholars deliberating over the implications of these discoveries. The revelation that such advanced knowledge existed during the Renaissance raised questions about the flow of information and the dissemination of ideas through history. Some attendees were skeptical, questioning the authenticity of the findings or the interpretation of the documents. Others were inspired, seeing the discoveries as a testament to the unyielding human spirit and the relentless pursuit of knowledge. Amidst the debates and discussions, Marco and Elena stood firm in their conviction. They emphasized the importance of these discoveries, not just as historical artifacts, but as reminders of the timeless quest for understanding and the importance of challenging established narratives. As the symposium drew to a close, Marco and Elena announced their intention to make the findings available to the public. They planned to collaborate with museums and educational institutions to create exhibitions and programs that would showcase the Renaissance group's legacy and its contributions to the advancement of human thought. The announcement was met with a mixture of acclaim and apprehension, but Marco and Elena were undeterred. They believed that the true value of their discovery lay in its ability to inspire and educate, to ignite curiosity and provoke thought. In the days following the symposium, the revelations about the Renaissance group became the subject of intense discussion in academic circles and the media. The story of Marco and Elena's discovery captured the imagination of the public, sparking a renewed interest in the Renaissance and its impact on the modern world. Marco and Elena, once solitary figures in their quest for the truth, had become the catalyst for a global re-examination of history. Their journey had started with a single, hidden message in a painting, but it had led to a revelation that echoed through the corridors of time. As they continued their work, collaborating with experts to further study and interpret the findings, Marco and Elena knew that their journey was far from over. They had uncovered a chapter of history that had been lost, but there were still many more secrets waiting to be discovered, more shadows to be explored. The legacy of the Renaissance group, with its blend of art, science, and philosophy, had been brought to light, challenging perceptions and opening doors to new understandings. The symposium was just the beginning, a first step in a journey that would continue to unravel the tapestry of history. In the heart of Rome, where the journey had begun, the shadows of the past had given way to a new dawn of knowledge and understanding. The story of Shadows of the Vatican was a testament to the enduring power of curiosity and the unquenchable human thirst for knowledge, a journey that had bridged the past and the present, revealing the timeless pursuit of truth and the indomitable spirit of exploration.